Hi, do you know that goosebumps can be a sign of a seizure and epilepsy? Well, this is a very weird information indeed, but it is true and we've seen it in many, many times. So here's what happens. In patients with temporal lobe epilepsy, especially in the right temporal lobe, when they have a seizure, it can affect the control of the autonomic system, which is the system that controls the skin tone and the hair as well, and all the heart rate and all of the automatic functions. And in that time, when the seizure happens, it will turn on the autonomic system and it will cause piloerection or goosebumps. And we have seen it in people who have epilepsy, temporal lobe epilepsy. When you bring them to the epilepsy monitoring unit, they will have this type of a seizure and it will be coming from the temporal lobe. So why this happens? So we think that the control of the autonomic function, where the skin tone and the heart rate, all of that happens in the brain, in the insula, and in the temporal lobe. And when there is a seizure in the temporal lobe, it will ignite that area and it will cause the goosebumps. So here are some interesting information. So if the goosebumps happens on only one side of the body, which can happen only on the right side or in the left side, it usually is coming from the temporal lobe of that similar side, because it seems that the control of the autonomic function is on the same side, not like the control of the movement, which is on the opposite side of the brain. If the goosebumps happens all over the body, then it will be not lateralized. So we don't know if it's right or left. So somebody will say, doctor, I have goosebumps all the time. Is this a seizure? Every time I sneeze or I just get excited, I will get goosebumps. So here's the thing. We should know that seizure is an electricity storm that happens in the brain, and usually it propagates from one area to another. So if it is goosebumps seizures, usually it is not isolated goosebumps and it is short. So usually it starts as goosebumps and then you will see that changes in the skin, and then it will propagate to other areas and then will start to have other symptoms. So you will have goosebumps and then you might feel weird, feel anxious, or like turn your head or start chewing your mouth or picking in yourself or pause and not be able to respond. So it's a consequence of events that makes it a seizure. So if you have like goosebumps every time you sneeze or every time you have excitement, it is likely not an epileptic seizure. And I know that lots of people have interacted with my tweet about goosebumps and saying, oh, this is like a seizure, I've been having seizures all my life. This is not a seizure likely. If you do not have epilepsy and clear seizures, goosebumps likely is not a seizure. All right, what are the possible causes of goosebumps related seizures? Well, most of them are temporal lobe epilepsy due to a scar, temporal mesial temporal sclerosis. And we have seen it and it was described in cases of inflammation in the brain, like paraneoplastic syndrome, autoimmune encephalitis, LGI syndrome, all of those kind of inflammation in the brain that cause inflammation, and specifically in the limbic system where the temporal lobe and the insula and the frontal lobe gets inflamed, and that can cause this type of a seizure. So how can we treat goosebumps related seizures? Well, the treatment of goosebumps related seizures is the same as we treat any other seizure. We start with medications, and usually they are successful in 50 to 70% of the time that will stop all the seizures and things will be okay. However, sometimes the seizures can be resistant to medication treatment and medicine will not work, and this happens about 25% of the time, and at that time we have to do some other treatments more successful. And usually if it is temporal lobe epilepsy, we can do surgery, and surgery can be resecting that area of the brain if the seizures are coming from all in that area, or we can implant devices in the neck or in the brain to cure the seizures and help them to stop. And seizures can present in so many different types, not just all shaking all over. And there are so many different types of seizure, depends on which area of the brain involved in the seizure. And to learn about all different types of seizures and epilepsy, you can see this video, and stay healthy and see you in the next one. Salam.